That was amazing. I can't wait for this next act, though. Bhangra is kind of how this whole thing started. A bunch of us performed in Red Square back in 1995, and then we performed at a Bhangra competition later in that spring semester. I guess the dance bug caught on at Georgetown, and then in the fall of 95, we did our first ever Rangila.
That's so amazing. I know that the thing I love most about this next dance is the name Bulldog Bhangra. It combines two of my favorite Georgetown traditions, Rangila and Jack the Bulldog.
I love Jack the Bulldog, but it's too bad we haven't had a real live mascot in over 20 years.
Oh, right, that's so weird. From the 70s until 99, you guys didn't have a dog. I would say that that's pretty rough. Oh. But one of my favorite stories was one that I was told from President DeGioia earlier tonight. His account with Bulldog Bhangra when his son was only 9 years old and came and sat along in the front row to watch a Rangila performance. And he loved Bhangra so much that that night, after being put to bed, he stayed up late, researched Bhangra online, and then woke up his parents to perform a Bhangra dance for them. And luckily, we were able to have him in the show next year, so he danced on stage when he was only 10 years old for Bulldog Bhangra.
I can't believe that. That's so awesome. So I think that means we have to get the next dance on stage. Bhangra is a traditional dance from the Indian subcontinent, originating in the Majha region of Punjab. In its earliest form, it was a celebratory folk dance to welcome the season of spring as part of the festival of Vaisakhi.
Nowadays, Bhangra has reached a global platform and has become integrated into popular West Asian and Western culture. I know that I am super excited to welcome
Bulldog Bhangra!
दुनिया तो जावा मुड़ फिर दोबारा आवा मैं जो भी जून हटावा मेरा देश होवे पंजाब
to go down.
Got the hammer in the ring.
फेर कर के ना करो
I got calls, calling, and your shekels fall. Where's Ali with them, I be ballin' like I'm like a brother more.